You seem very excited for today.
I am. I'm very excited for this debate. I think it's a very important debate for our viewers and for us to deal with.
That's right. Dan and I have discussed, and we have decided it's time to decide what is this generation's Star Wars.
Generation Y. So to further clarify, Generation Y are people who were born 1980s forward. And it's nebulous, but that's the definition we're going off
of. It's weird, because we're not Generation X.
MTV.
And we're not Generation I, because that's... I think that's what the current people growing up now are, past the year 2000.
Really?
I don't know. It's all stupid. But what's not stupid is the next Star Wars. And that... have to say is Harry Potter. And that could be both movies and books. Like, the whole Harry Potter thing has taken the spot that Star Wars has left wide open to take. This is a huge culture explosion. Every which way you turn, wizards are popping up here and making fun of the muggles over there. People are constantly debating what Rowling was thinking here and there, and she's constantly making changes and being all...
She is weird.
She's weird.
I don't know. I have not seen all of the Harry Potter movies.
I haven't even seen the last two, and I don't have to. I've read the books.
But
I know.
That's just it. Star Wars, you had to see them. To be part of the culture, you had to see Star Wars.
Well, we're not just talking movies here, because I'm saying I finished the book series, and you had to finish the book series.
I haven't read any of the books.
Well, that's fine. You finished the movie series, haven't you?
No, I haven't finished all the movies.
Well, then you're just not partaking in this generation's Star Wars, Dan.
But I am, because this generation's Star Wars is The Lord of the Rings.
Lord of the Rings was, like, before Star Wars. That was way back. When was Lord of the Rings originally?
That's the books. I'm talking about...
The books are huge, Dan.
Movies from New Zealand that are just so great that every year the Oscars happened, everybody else just gave up. They're like,
no,
well,
they didn't.
It's a Lord of the Ring year.
They did not give up. Lord of the Rings did not win that much in the first two times it came out. It was only until the last one when everyone was like, okay.
It won 11 Oscars.
When Return of the King came out, Return of the King swept.
That's one of them. Chris, The Lord of the Rings, this is not each movie is the further adventures of Captain Frodo. This is one long adventure. One adventure so grand it needed three movies of enormous stature. Just this, he's gotta go, and it's so far, and he develops friendships and everything. With Harry Potter, it's like, oh, it's another year at high school or college or wherever at. Pip, pip, cheerio. I wonder who my teacher will be, who's clearly the villain, because that's how it works.
Okay, so you just shot your own argument in the foot, I do believe.
I did?
Yes, you did. Because Lord of the Rings, fantastic set of movies. I'm not saying that that's the criteria for what judges Star Wars.
My final word is...
The thing is, Star Wars is alright. But Star Wars, more than just being some good movies, were a cultural phenomenon. Yours was a phenomenon. Thing was, Harry Potter took over, took books, and said, these are ours now. Rowling started getting awards for getting kids to read again, even though all they were doing was reading her books. That's how big it was. All of a sudden, reading was cool again, as long as you're reading Harry Potter or things similar to Harry Potter. The explosion of the wizarding slash fantastical journeys happened everywhere. Everywhere. And movies as well. We're like, we gotta find the next Harry Potter. We gotta do it.
Well, that's because they wanted to cash in on
it. Lord of the Rings popped up and everyone said, these are really good movies. And people said, there are books about those. These are really good movies.
People were reading the Lord of the Rings books before Harry Potter existed.
People have been reading Lord of the Rings for ages. I mean, D&D is pretty much based off of Lord of the Rings. It's not the Star Wars of our generation. If you're going to try to say something crazy about Lord of the Rings, you're going to have to put it back in its origin point. With us, we got the movies, and all we do is talk about these movies, but we talk about, oh, those are really cool movies. We don't go to big conventions and stuff about it. We just not Lord of the Rings has not just breached every bit of our culture the way that Harry Potter has breached it.
They're making The Hobbit. People are flipping Facebook page all over the place.
People are excited about the Avengers movie. Good movies can be fun. You can have a good movie, but this is not. Lord of the Rings is not just making the world change because of it. Harry Potter changed the rules.
That's what I say to you. You know, I think it's a bigger feat for Lord of the Rings books to be considered classics before reading was, you know, oh, everybody's got to read and find the next Hunger Games or Harry Potter or this teen, you know, reading material. I mean, Lord of the Rings movies won Oscars, and Harry Potter, it just really made money.
It's all about the money, Dan!
What you guys talking about?
Kyle, we're talking about what is this generation's Star Wars. Yeah. I'm saying that it's clearly Harry Potter.
Oh, it's Lord of the Rings all the way.
No,
why didn't you guys call me?
What? What have you got, Kyle?
I don't know your number.
Obviously, this generation's Star Wars, I mean, you're going to laugh at this, but it's the truth. Star Wars.
Oh, I'm not smiling anymore.
The prequels, man. And hey, this generation's doesn't mean that they're good. It means that it encapsulates this generation.
Ooh.
And if there is a trilogy that encapsulates this generation, it's definitely the prequel Star Wars movies.
Are we going to need a three-way debate here?
Let it be so!
Oh, no!
Bum, bum, bum!
Bum, bum, bum!
Bum,